Ladies.
And what are you going to do?
Say play.
Much of it happening at Splash, mobilizing knowledge, the virtual and the real, advancing citizen science, and advancing experiential tourism with economic returns. So that means, and that's a lot of hard language about, there could be a way for various kiosks around the lake, various areas where you can access information on your smartphone. There could be ways for you to change and add information on your smartphone so that the Lake Simcoe area as a whole would be known as a place that loved nature and brought people together by collecting their ideas and helping them share information.
So you can right there. This is a book about kids asking questions about Lake Simcoe. It is really a legacy project for us. To create a piece that kids can read with their parents and with their grandparents and in their schools, and the teachers can access. So all the things that kids wanted to know about Lake Simcoe.
And it was a wonderful woman from the federal Environment Canada to tell us.
She was right here.
Yes, she was the last.
She was at our
last meeting. And she was calling to tell me that she was very pleased to tell us that our application for Lake Simcoe Georgian Bay Cleanup Fund funding had been successful. Mm-hmm. And not only had it been successful, it had been successful to the tune of just over $1 million.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Now, as Margaret said, you know, this money is what's it's a multi-year funding, so we have about 3.5 years now on the clock for approximately 24 projects that we will be engaging in all around.
So many things going on. I mean, so many great volunteers and partners, and really, you know, great collaborations. And in fact, one of our volunteers that we met through Splash Gale is actually now a new member of the Ladies of the Building. Splash was really successful this year in a number of ways. I was trying to categorize how I would express it to you guys. That for me, I look at the collaborations and the partnerships that we built as our biggest success. Because we really had a great mission to try to help people love Lake Simcoe. That was our overall arching mission for all of our different events. And so many people came together at all different levels from all, you know, whether it was the media or volunteers or people that were, you know, providing content, everyone came together and worked really well together, and I think that in itself is a huge success and really bodes well in the ladies of the lake and moving forward the way the ladies of the lake have always worked as a team. We also had success in numbers. We had the biggest numbers so far. We had 5,000 people out between all four events. We incorporated a new event which took place in Beaverton, the Big Bite, which a lot of you were at. And that was nice because it was a collaboration. So it wasn't us running it, it was them running it, working with us to help them make their event better and bigger and, you know, work with the watershed and teach people how much, you know, what we eat and where we get our food from relates to the health of the lake. We had our forest event again, and it was at a different forest in York Region, and that was neat to bring in different people. We did Moonapalooza, which was an interesting experiment in itself, and that was at Sibyl's Point, and that was a very spiritual sort of event, but it was well received nonetheless.
We had about 500 people there.
Yeah.
The weather was not so friendly.
No.
but you did see that, the clouds parted and you did see the
Yeah, and the lake was so beautiful. Tumult and exciting, and it really added to the energy of the event. But I think we're moving forward even more this year with really great partnerships, and we're even looking at hopefully expanding into Innisfil. And we're talking with Beverly and her group about the possibility of bringing her Celebrate Lake Simcoe into the whole mix. That would be good, eh? They would bring the whole heritage part of it in. So, trying to think of what other great exciting things I could share. We did a lot of research, entrance interviews of people came in, and surveys just to find out why people came out and where they heard about Splash. And the number one reason people came out, we've discovered, was for fun. So, you know, it's a great catalyst to get people there. And then when they're there, we can, you know, teach them what we want them to know in fun ways, and make sure that they're really loving the lake from that perspective. Moving forward this year, now we've already started, and we're plowing full steam ahead, and we're working really hard on trying to figure out funding and what events we're going to do, and staffing strategies, and all sorts of high-level stuff, but it's shaping up to be really great. We had a goal about a month and a half prior to the beach splash, from a power boating organization saying, we are having a poker run the day of your beach splash, and we really believe in what you're doing, and we're trying to change our image, and we would really love to do a drive-by at Splash, a parade of sorts to salute what you're doing. So I wrote back and copied Annabelle and a few other people and said, I think it's fantastic. You know, we all need to work together, no matter where we're coming from, to work at helping this lake. I went on and on about how proud we would be for them to do this drive-by. And I sent off my email thinking, I'm so happy. And then I get this email from Annabelle in capital, no! There are royal Emmys! So we have a discussion about it. She says, okay, maybe it would be good if we all work together, and it could actually give a really great message out there. Like, you know, we do need to work together, and, you know, as much as she's tried to take her BB gun and kill the driver, they go by.
I'm with you.
Yeah! So then she contacted Tim Crusell?
Yeah, M-O-A.
And he had the same reaction she did at first. But then we all started to, you know, get on the same page and realize this would be a good message. And then at the same time, Johanna had set up Jackson's Point Sailing Club. Is that what it's called?
Sail Georgina.
They were going to do a regatta or a race of sorts.
They race.
And they were going to depart from the beach at De La Salle at around 10, and then they would come back after their race there. So we had to figure out how to make, because we heard that sailors hate the power boaters too, so we had to try to figure out how to make this all work. Anyways, to make a long story short, it ended up working so beautifully, and maybe even Margaret could tell, like, when it all occurred, the sailboats were out there and the power boaters came by.
They came by, they cut their engines.
I can see it.
They waited until everybody was there, and then they did a sail by in respect, in formation, in front of Splash. The horrible stink pot boats and the sailboats together. And it was just such a show of solidarity and affirmation of what we're doing. And we really are moving even the sides we thought were immovable.
Did they cut their noise when they did that?
It was quiet.
Yeah, so they can actually,
relatively speaking.
They can actually go without that horrible noise if they choose.
They just can't go fast.
And they're trying to reduce their emissions, and they're trying to add their noise.
No, the performance boat club is trying to gather members together to cut their emissions, cut their noise emissions, cut their other emissions. Ooh. So they, you know, there is movement.
And the rule of the water is sail over power anyway.
Right away.
That was started. Annabelle and Pat Bell, myself,
just won a grant from Freshwater Future to work with Oromandante and the public to keep the greens, the woodlands and the wetlands intact in the township of Oromandante. The Rescue Lake Simcoe Protection Plan states policy 6.23 that no development is to be done on woodlands or wetlands anywhere in the watershed. And
I don't understand that. Where's development going to take place then? Wouldn't it be on woodlands or something?
No, it takes place in the rural settlement areas. It takes place in the rural settlement areas.
I see.
Which have been for a long time been slated for development. So, and we're just waiting for the Ministry of Natural Resources to define exactly what a woodland and a wetland is. Mm-hmm. And so far they've defined a woodland to be practically any woods bigger than half a hectare. And a wetland is defined to be anything. So if those definitions are accepted, then in a stroke we're going to save all the woodlands and wetlands.
Wow.
But Oromandante is in the process of revising its official plan, so we're going to work with them and with the public to make sure that the official plan conforms to the Lake Simcoe Protection Plan and that they save the woodlands and wetlands.
The Rescue Lake Simcoe was formed July 2003. And Pat Bell and Annabelle, myself, are founding members amongst other people.
Okay.
And we've been working hard since then to improve the quality of the water flowing into Lake Simcoe.
And maybe you can tell me a name.
Tim Crooks. My name is Tim Crooks.
All right. And where can we find you? In Oromandante?
Oromandante, bottom of line 2.
Okay.
Turn right, 10th house on the lake.
Wow. There we go. Okay. Rooting for that Rescue Lake Simcoe.
Rescue Lake Simcoe Coalition signing off. Thank you for introducing me.
There we go.